I'm at least at bat reporting.
But here's another difference. It's very, very hard to be famous in boxing. It's hard. There are fighters that I know that are champions right now that nobody knows who they are.
Yeah.
They can walk down the street and they have every title you can imagine. Yeah. You're famous now. The movies help, the social media, the controversy, it doesn't matter.
Yeah.
But it sells and people tune in. Yeah. So that's a big advantage for networks or promoters to approach you.
You know what, man? It's true, bro, because that's how I look at it. But in boxing, bro, it's what the promoters, what they think is best, what they
want
to do.
They want their guy to win easy.
And it's like, man, it's like sometimes I get blown away by the guys that get pushed. And I'm not hating on nobody, bro. You know what I mean? I want anybody to make money and come up with whatever. But sometimes I'm like blown away by the guys that are being pushed that are not marketable, can't talk, can't hold an interview, you know what I'm saying, have no personality, and are not really that entertaining in the ring. And then these guys are getting pushed.
Why?
You know what I'm saying? I don't know.
Because their manager is the percentage.
A fighter like me who's willing to fight, willing to fight anybody, you know what I'm saying, and it's entertaining, you know what I'm saying.
You've been in a lot of controversial losses to you, which means that you may have won the Kid Chocolate. A lot of people thought you won. I'm cool with Kid.
You know what I mean?
And I haven't talked to him in a while, but you talked to him about that fight ever?
You know, the commentators had me up on that fight, you know, on the scorecards. You know, the J Love fight, the commentators had me up on that fight as well.
That was on the Mayweather card, right? That was on one of the Mayweather fights, right?
Yeah, that was when Floyd fought Guerrero. You know what I'm saying? So, like, now I've had a couple controversies, but, like, I look past that.
Of course. No, but I'm saying controversy sells.
Yeah.
So if people say, oh, you see Gabriel Rosado fight, he won, he got robbed, he won, whatever. Like, your last fight in England.
Yeah.
Maybe people would not pay attention because it ended controversy. Everybody had to go back and watch it.
Man, I came back and I was so surprised how many people saw the fight. I was getting people, like, coming at me from everywhere, bro. Like, I was like, what? Like, the fight was in London, Sky TV on their time. So many people seen the fight, man. And it's like, when I came back, man, I just had so many people like, damn, God, I thought you pulled it off. And it was crazy. So was crazy. I mean, even the love that I got from the UK, man, they, like, the fans were like,
they know
I'm embarrassed of Brit boxing. You know what I'm saying? I'm embarrassed for British boxing. So, you know, they're showing me love. But, yeah, I mean, I don't know what it is, bro. I don't know what it is with the promoters that, you know, they don't see the big picture and they say, look, man, this guy's entertaining. I mean, this guy, you know, his ratings are good when he's on. I mean, when I'm on, my ratings are good, bro. Like, I know my numbers. Like, I do my information. I mean, I look it up.
I was just going to ask you about that because I know some real big stars that only...
Listen, I know that when I fight, my numbers are bigger than guys that are, you know, considered stars. And I'm not taking that from nobody, but... I mean, I know this, bro. Like, I've seen it.
Mayweather says men lie, women lie.
Yeah.
Numbers don't lie.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
No, I'm aware of it, too, because I know the numbers.
Yeah.
But you just have to stay in shape because...
You know, when you fight on HBO, bro, if you get a million that tuned in on
that's
HBO...
That's huge.
Bro, that's big.
That is big.
Bro, when I headlined on HBO, bro, I headlined against a guy that it was his first time fighting in the States. No one knew who he was. And the ratings did almost like 1.2 or something like that.
That is a lot.
That's a lot, bro.
It is.
And look, and then this guy fights Triple G on pay-per-view, and they couldn't do, what, 100,000?
84,000.
84,000 on pay-per-view. But I'm just saying, like, at the end of the day, if it's about putting asses in seats and ratings, then I mean, that's what I present. But then I get, you know, I always get the BS from the promoters. Whoa, Gabe, you didn't win your last fight.
Well,
but look, technically, you know that I really did. Technically, I didn't, but you know I really did. So let's not play dumb, you know. But that's how it is.
So there you have it, another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Sekpak reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter @Sekpak, and you can follow me on Instagram @Ellie Sekpak.